This morning, Russia has pushed Ukrainian forces back from the center of Severodonetsk. This is a key city in the eastern part of the country, really the crucial city to Russia's goal of gaining control over the entire region, the entire eastern part of Ukraine. Let's go to Kyiv now. We're joined by CNN's Matthew Chance, who is there. And in a way, the battle for this part of the country has reached this critical stage where it's become this fierce back and forth effort, and the sides are getting worn down, Matthew.
Yeah, they are getting worn down, John. And, you know, still Ukrainian forces are fighting street to street there. But there's been a stark message this morning from Kremlin forces in and around that city to Ukrainian troops, basically saying leave, surrender, or face death or die. That's the message coming from these rebel groups backed by Russia, as well as the Russian military, of course, as Russia continues to make, you know, slow but definite progress in that key city.
There's no end in sight to this war, but its horror is plain to see. An old woman crosses herself in prayer as troops fight street to street. It's the battle here, in and around the city of Severodonetsk, where the Ukrainian president says the fate of Donbas in eastern Ukraine is being decided. But it seems more a case of when, not if, this devastated region will fall into Russian hands. And the embattled Ukrainian president is again expressing his frustration. Ukraine needs modern missile defense systems, he says in his latest address. Did we get them? No. Do we need them? Yes. On both sides, there are signs of fatigue setting in. But these latest images from the Russian Defense Ministry show its forces on the offensive. A squadron of attack helicopters hitting what Russian military officials say are Ukrainian positions. Target hit, the pilot reports. Thanks very much, guys. God be with you, comes the response. By concentrating its fire, Russia appears to be gaining momentum.
Operational Tactical and Army Aviation hit three Ukrainian command posts in 25 areas of concentration of manpower and military equipment. As a result, more than 150 Ukrainian nationals, six tanks, five field artillery pieces, and 10 special vehicles for various purposes were destroyed.
Of course, Russia is paying a heavy price for waging this war, what it calls its special military operation, in Ukraine too. It's estimated to have lost thousands of troops and countless tanks and other armored vehicles, some of which have been placed here in the center of the capital Kiev on public display. But nearly 4 months into this grinding and relentless conflict, Ukraine seems dangerously outnumbered and outgunned. From the Black Sea, Russia's naval bombardment continues apace. These four cruise missiles fired at a warehouse of anti-tank weapons supplied by the United States and its allies, according to the Russian military. Ukraine says the missiles hit mostly residential areas in the west of the country, injuring 22 civilians, including a 12-year-old child. Of course, Ukrainian forces are fighting back, like here near the northeastern city of Kharkiv, where they say this old captured Russian rocket launcher has been turned on the invaders. But Ukrainian officials say they need many more long-range weapons from the US and its Western allies if they are to push or even hold the Russians back.
Well, John, when they say more, they mean a lot more. Ukrainian officials, rather, are talking about the need for heavy weapons parity with Russia in order for them to end this war. And they say that means hundreds of tanks, hundreds of rocket launcher systems like the one we just saw, and more sophisticated ones, artillery pieces, armored vehicles, drones, all over and above the $40 billion in military aid the Biden administration has already pledged.
They want more, not just to hold the Russians back, but ultimately they hope to try to push them out. And it's hard to imagine how that would happen. Matthew Chance for us in Kyiv, thank you so much.